under the canopy of the plants. I think when the plan was first done, it was for sumac trees, which FHL, members of FHL said, sumac trees won't get that big, let's do something more higher impact. Then I think they considered black locusts, which I think some members of FHL said, let's do something more fun. And so most of what we have here, well, there's four types of magnolias. The big-leafed ones are big-leafed magnolias. There's Magnolia macrophylla, Magnolia macrophylla variety ashii, and Magnolia tripetala. And then there's the smaller one is the swamp magnolia, Magnolia virginiana. Yeah, between that and the sumac, yeah, so we're excited for this to kind of grow up, you know, and there's a really great, as gardeners for us, it's a completely different plant palette. There's ferns down there, there's adiantum, pedantum, the Christmas fern, Pelignum acrosticoides, and the Korean tassel fern, this is probably the farm. We have epimedium in there, we have Polygonatum, the Solomon seal, we have Tiarella, we have Astrantia. It's just all because it's shadier in here, yeah. And we also don't have gravel mulch in here. This was one of our areas that we identified as an area that a lot of those plants are so tender that they wouldn't do well with the gravel mulch. So this is one of our trial areas. Definitely got a lot of weeds here this summer. I think our intern spent most of his time weeding up here. But he was great about it.
Does the tassel fern do well?
I think the ferns have been doing pretty well so far, yeah. Again, a lot of them were planted this spring, so we'll see how they do in the summer and in the winter. There's two types of azaleas, the swamp azalea, and there's Rhododendron viscosum and Rhododendron atlanticum. My common names are sloppy. The dwarf azalea is the other one. This is a cool kind of different perspective. This is a really great chance. You'll see, literally, it's like moguls around the root balls of these trees. That's the way they're able to bring in larger trees, and it kind of creates this depth. And once the understory grows in, I think it'll be really cool. One of the things I think is really interesting is, like, this is, like I said, a chance for people to come up. People are asking me all day, when are we going to get to go under? And it's just kind of like, no, the point is that you're above. So people always want what they can't have, I think. We have this path, yeah, it's available to us, and you can get in. I mean, on a crowded day, our maintenance staff will have, like, buckets of trash that they cannot get through up here, so they have this path then, which is great for them.
Well, I also think people see a camp.
Yeah, they want to walk on it.